بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. This is lecture number 31 from the course Applied Chemistry. I am Dr. Riyaz Hussain. Topic of our today discussion is scale prevention in boiler. In this lecture, we will discuss how the scale is formed and how scale formation within the boiler is prevented. Key concepts. Following concepts will be covered in this lecture. First of all, we will discuss major sources of water. Then we will discuss major impurities present in water, disadvantages of hard water, what is boiler and what is boiler feed water, what are boiler problems. After this, we will discuss formation of sludge and scale, and then we will discuss disadvantages of sludge and scale formation. All these concepts will be discussed in detail, and we will try to build our concept regarding these points. Sources of water. There are two major sources of water. One source is the surface water and the other one is the underground water. Surface water includes rain water, river water, lake water as well as sea water. Rain water is a pure water, but it may contaminated with gases like CO2, NO2, etc. River water contain high dissolved salts and also some, or we can say moderate amount of organic material may present in the river water. Lake water have constant composition, but lake water is enriched with organics material. Sea water contain high salinity, pathogens and enrich in organics material. The other source of water is the underground water. We can say well water. The underground water is taken out either through well or through the null or through pumping. The underground water is crystal clear but may contain high dissolved salts and high purity, and this water is highly pure from organics. The underground water contain salts, minerals like minerals of heavy metals, but it is free from organics material, and the underground water is crystal clear as well. Major impurities of water. Major impurities of water are divided into two parts. One is the ionic and dissolved impurities, and the other one is the non-ionic and undissolved impurity. The third type of impurities may be the gases. The gases contain CO2, H2S, NH3, CH4, O2. These gases may be dissolved in the water. Non-ionic and undissolved impurities which may present in the water: turbidity, silt, mud, dirt and other suspended matter, color, plankton, organic matter, microorganisms, bacteria, silica, sand, etc. These are the non-ionic and undissolved impurities present in the water. Ionic and dissolved impurities, it may be the cationic and may be anionic, like cationic calcium, magnesium, and their calcium and magnesium may present in the form of their bicarbonates or carbonates or in the form of hydroxides. Sodium, potassium, ammonium, iron, manganese, these metals may present in the form of sulfate, chloride, nitrate or phosphate form. So these दीज आर द आयनिक एंड डिजॉल्व्ड इम्प्योरिटीज विच मे प्रेजेंट इन द वाटर. ड्रॉबैक्स आर डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ हार्ड वाटर. इफ द वाटर taken from its sources is the hard water, then that water can be used for domestic purpose and that water may also be used for industrial purposes. The use of water for domestic purpose is its use in washing. It is also used for bathing, for drinking, as well as it is used for cooking purpose. If the water is the hard water, when the hard water is used for washing, then the washing is not done properly in the presence of hard water. What happened when hard water is used for washing? Then the sticky precipitates adheres on the fabric cloth and gives spots and streaks. If hard water is due to the presence of iron metals, then iron salts stains the clothes. If the hard water is used for bathing, then the hard water produces sticky scum on the bathtub as well as on the body. The soap during bathing purpose form a scum and do not form the leather in the presence of hard water. Water used for drinking purpose. If it's a hard water, then it is not fit for the body. It's bad to the digestive system and it causes various problems in our digestive tracts. It may also cause calcium oxalate formation in the urinary tract. The hard water is not fit for cooking purpose as well. If it is used for cooking, then it requires more fuel and more time. Certain food do not cook soft and also gives unpleasant taste in presence of hard water. Water may also be used for industrial purpose. It is used in textile industry. It is also used in sugar industry. It is used in dyeing industry. It also used in paper industry and it is also used in pharmaceutical industry. Water, if it is a hard water, then it is also used in boiler for generation of the steam, and that steam run the turbines which is connected with the generator to produce electricity. Boiler. Because our topic of today's discussion is the scale prevention in the boiler. So what is boiler? Boiler is a device for generating steam. It consists of two principal parts. The first part of the boiler is the furnace, which provides heat by burning of fuel, usually by burning of fuel. And the other part is a boiler proper. Boiler, a device in which the heat changes water into steam. The water enters into the boiler. The heat from the furnace converts the water into the steam. The steam or hot fluid is then recirculated out of the boiler for use in various processes, in heating applications, including water heating, including central heating, boiler based power generation, cooking and sanitation. So the use of boiler water is not only for the generation of electricity, it may also be used for the heating purpose, for central heating purpose, for cooking as well as for sanitation. Proper treatment of boiler feed water is an important part of operating and maintaining a boiler system. As steam is produced, dissolved solids become concentrated and form deposits inside the boiler. This leads to poor heat transfer and reduces the efficiency of the boiler. The water coming from the water source, that is the सरफेस वाटर सोर्स आर द अंडरग्राउंड वाटर सोर्स दैट वाटर मे कंटेन सम डिजॉल्व्ड मटेरियल्स. इफ डिजॉल्व्ड मटेरियल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द वाटर एंड दैट वाटर इज फीडेड टू द बॉयलर ड्यूरिंग हीटिंग सिस्टम द डिजॉल्व्ड मटेरियल प्रेजेंट इन द वाटर कन्वर्टेड इन टू द अनडिजॉल्व मटेरियल एंड दैट अनडिजॉल्व मटेरियल स्टक ऑन द इनर वॉल ऑफ द बॉयलर. एज ए रिजल्ट द इनर डायमीटर ऑफ द बॉयलर बिकम नैरो विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम. वट वुड बी द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ यूजिंग सच वाटर विच कंटेन डिजॉल्व्ड मटेरियल. एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ यूजिंग सच टाइप ऑफ वाटर the use of fuel will be high, it will be expensive process. With the passage of time the boiler become useless because of deposits of salts on the inner wall of the boiler, and the efficiency of the boiler reduces with the passage of the time as well. Boiler feed water Boiler feed water is a water that undergoes purification or preheating and is then supplied to boilers for hot water and steam production, or it can remain still. It is typically found in thermal power plants where it is stored and conditioned in tanks. That water is known as boiler feed water. Boiler feed water means the water feeded to the boiler. The water coming from the water source is subjected to condition and purification so that the dissolved or undissolved materials from the water can be removed out, and then that purified and conditioned water is feeded to the boiler. That water is called the boiler feed water. The boiler feed water should have following composition. Its hardness should be below to 0.2 parts per million. Its caustic alkalinity due to hydroxide ion. Its soda alkalinity due to sodium bicarbonate should be 0.45 to 1 ppm. These are the requirements. The water which is free from minerals will be good for the boiler feed water. Boiler problems. The water feeded to the boiler, what type of problems raised by that water within the boiler are called boiler problems. Boiler problem, scales and sludge formation, priming, foaming, carryover, boiler corrosion, as well as caustic embrittlement. These are the six boiler problems. Boiler troubles due to hard water. If hard water is fed to the boiler, then that hard water may create following problems within the boiler. It may cause scale and sludge formation. It can cause caustic embitterment, caustic embitterment, priming and foaming, boiler corrosion. These four are the major problems which can be caused by the use of hard water. See, this is the orange color is the boundary of the boiler wall. It's a boiler wall, and this is the water, and this the lines showing in this area is actually the precipitates, which can be slimy loose precipitate called sludge, which are suspended in the water. Sludge is a soft, loose and slimy precipitate formed within the boiler. इट कैन बी इजिली स्क्रैप्ड ऑफ विद अ वायर ब्रश. इट इज फॉर्म एट कंपेरेटिवली कोल्डर पोर्शन ऑफ द बॉयलर एंड कलेक्ट्स इन एरियाज ऑफ द सिस्टम वेयर द फ्लो रेट इज स्लो आर एट बेंड्स. द स्लज इज फॉर्म इन द कोल्डर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉयलर एंड कलेक्ट्स इन एरियाज वेयर द वाटर फ्लो रेट इज स्लो. एट दैट पार्ट द स्लज विल सेटल डाउन और इट मे सेटल डाउन इन द बेंड्स इन द टर्न्स प्रेजेंट इन द बॉयलर वेयर द एट द टर्न्स द फ्लो रेट ऑफ द वाटर इज ऑल्सो स्लो डाउन. इट इज फॉर हाउ द स्लज इज फॉर्म. इट इज फॉर्म बाई सब्सटांसिस विच हैव ग्रेटर सॉल्युबिलिटीज इन हॉट वाटर देन इन कोल्ड वाटर e.g. मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट मैग्नीशियम क्लोराइड कैल्शियम क्लोराइड मैग्नीशियम सल्फेट एटसेट्रा. स्लज फॉर्म्ड इन द बॉयलर कैन बी रिमूव्ड यूजिंग वायर ब्रश और माइल्ड एसिड. स्लज एंड स्केल फॉर्मेशन इन बॉयलर्स. इन बॉयलर वाटर इज कंटिन्यूअसली एवेपोरेटेड टू फॉर्म स्टीम. एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ एवेपोरेशन द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ डिजॉल्व्ड सॉल्ट्स इंक्रीजेस. फाइनली अ स्टेज इज रीच्ड व्हेन द आयनिक प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दीज सॉल्ट्स एक्सीड्स देयर सॉल्युबिलिटी प्रोडक्ट्स. एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस दीज सॉल्ट्स आर थ्रोन एज प्रेसिपिटेट्स. इफ द प्रेसिपिटेट्स फॉर्म आर सॉफ्ट एंड स्लिमी देन they are known as sludges, while if the precipitates are hard and adhering into the inner wall then it is called scale. So water feed to the boiler may contain some dissolved salts. If the solubility of these dissolved salts is high in colder water and less in hot water, as the temperature rises in the boiler then the solubility of these dissolved salts become lesser and these salts precipitates out and these precipitates may be form the sludge or may be form the scales. If the precipitates are soft and loose then these precipitates are called sludges. And sludge can easily be removed through wire brush. If the precipitates are harder and adhering on the wall of the boiler, then it is called scale. And removal of scale from the wall of the boiler is difficult process. In this slide, Ay plus and Bx negative are the ionic concentrations of the electrolyte present in the saturated solution. Ay plus is showing the cation and Bx negative is showing the anion. The solubility product of an electrolyte may be defined as maximum product of the concentration of constituent ions present in the solution when each ionic concentration term being raised to the number of times the ions occur in the equation representing the solution of one molecule of the electrolyte. See the cases. KSP, solubility product constant. If solubility product constant is equal to the product of cation and anion, then the solution is just saturated. If solubility product constant of substance is greater than product of cation and anion, or we can say solubility product is greater than ionic product of the substance. Here the solubility product is equal to the ionic product. When solubility product is equal to the ionic product of the substance, then the solution is just saturated. If solubility product is greater than ionic product of the substance, then the solution is unsaturated, and it means more salt can be dissolved in it. If solubility product constant is less than ionic product constant of a substance, or we can say solubility product is less than ionic product, it means solid AXBY will precipitate out. If solubility product is less than ionic product, then it means the solid substance in the form of a compound will be precipitated out. So, when a water containing dissolved salts is fed to the boiler and the solubility of the dissolved salts is greater in cold water and lesser in hot water, with the passage of time, as the temperature rises and water evaporated, then the solution become concentrated and the dissolved substance converted to the precipitates and settle down in the bottom. That is called either sludge or the scale. And the formation of precipitate is due to the difference in the solubility product as well as the ionic product constant of water. If the solubility product constant is less than ionic product constant, then the solid precipitate out in the form of salt. Sludge is a soft, loose and slimy precipitate formed within the boiler. Sludges are formed by substances which have greater solubilities in hot water than cold water, e.g. magnesium carbonate, magnesium chloride, calcium chloride and magnesium sulfate. They are formed at comparatively in colder portions of the boiler and get collected at places where the flow rate is slow. They can be easily removed, I mean scraped off, with a wire brush. If sludges are formed along with scales, then former gets entrapped in the latter and both get deposited as a scale. If sludges are formed along with scales, then sludges gets entrapped in the scales, means both merge with one another and both get deposited in the form of scale on the inner walls of the boiler, and then its removal is difficult task. Disadvantages of sludge formation. Sludges are poor conductors, so they tend to waste a portion of heat generated and thus decreases the efficiency of boiler. Excessive sludge formation disturbs the working of the boiler. It settles in the regions of poor water circulation, such as pipe, connection, plug opening, gauge glass connection, thereby causing even blocking of the pipes. Prevention of sludge formation. How the sludge formation is prevented? If we use soft water, then sludge formation will not occur. By frequently blow down operation, i.e. partial removal of concentrated water through a tap at the bottom of boiler, when extent of hardness in the boiler becomes alarmingly high. By removal of concentrated water through a tap at the bottom of boiler, when extent of hardness in the boiler becomes alarmingly high. By continuously removing the sludge from the bottom of the boiler by using a tap, it also increase the efficiency of the boiler because we are continuously removing sludge form within the colder part of the boiler. Scales are hard deposits firmly sticking to the inner surface of the boiler. They are difficult to remove even with the help of hammer and chisel and are the main source of boiler troubles. Scales are harder in nature while sludges are looser in nature. The removal of sludge is easy process. The sludge can be removed through a wire brush, but the removal of scale is a very difficult process. Even its removal with hammer is also a difficult task. Causes of formation of scales. Scales may be formed inside the boiler due to, first one, the decomposition of calcium bicarbonate. It means the water which is fed to the boiler is a hard water. The hard water is the water which contains bicarbonates of calcium or magnesium, or we can say chlorides of calcium and magnesium, or the hard water may contain sulfates of calcium and magnesium. Bicarbonates, chlorides as well as sulfates of calcium and magnesium present in the water in a soluble form, in the dissolved form. The question is, the hardness causing substances are the salts of calcium or magnesium, or the salts of other metals may also cause the hardness. Yes, we can say other salts of other metals like heavy metals including iron may also cause hardness of the water. If water fed to the boiler is a hard water and the hardness is due to the presence of calcium bicarbonate, then remember, bicarbonates, chlorides or sulfates are soluble in water at lower temperature. As the temperature of water rises, then these salts converted to the other compounds which can cause scale formation. See, first one, if the hard water contain calcium bicarbonate, then upon rising of the temperature the calcium bicarbonate get decomposes. Calcium bicarbonate upon decomposition, upon heating, converted to calcium carbonate, that is insoluble. Calcium bicarbonate soluble in the water. When upon heating it is converted to the calcium carbonate, these calcium carbonates are insoluble in the insoluble material, settle down in the bottom and firmly sticks on the walls of the boiler. With the formation of calcium carbonate, water and CO2 is also produced. CO2 is a gas removed from the surface of the water. However, scale composed chiefly of calcium carbonate is soft and is the main cause of scale formation in low pressure boiler. So, low pressure boiler, the scale formed in the low pressure boiler is due to the accumulation of calcium carbonate, and scale consisting of only calcium carbonate material is the soft scale. But in high pressure boilers, this calcium carbonate under high pressure becomes soluble and form the calcium hydroxide. Calcium carbonate get dissolved in water at high pressure and it gives us calcium hydroxide soluble. It means calcium carbonate becomes soluble at high pressure with the evolution of carbon dioxide gas. So if the water fed to the boiler contain calcium bicarbonate, then with the rise of temperature in the boiler, the calcium bicarbonate converted to the calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate are insoluble in water and settle down on the inner walls of the boiler. सो द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट इज एक्चुअली द स्केल एंड दिस इज अ सॉफ्ट स्केल फॉर्मेशन, सॉफ्ट सॉफ्ट नेचर स्केल. डीकम्पोजिशन ऑफ कैल्शियम सल्फेट, द सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ कैल्शियम सल्फेट इन वाटर डिक्रीजेज विद इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर. कैल्शियम सल्फेट इज सॉल्युबल इन कोल्ड वाटर बट ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटली इनसॉल्युबल इन सुपर हीटेड वाटर. इट मे बी ड्यू टू इंक्रीज्ड आयोनाइजेशन एट हाई टेम्परेचर, सो के एस पी बिकम लेस देन के आयनिक प्रोडक्ट एंड लेस अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स फॉर सॉल्वेशन एट हाई टेम्परेचर. एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ राइज ऑफ टेम्परेचर कैल्शियम सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ कैल्शियम सल्फेट डिक्रीज एंड कैल्शियम सल्फेट बिकम कन्वर्टेड टू द प्रेसिपिटेट एंड सेटल डाउन इन द बॉटम. कॉन्सिक्वेंटली कैल्शियम सल्फेट गेट्स प्रेसिपिटेटेड एज हार्ड स्केल ऑन द हॉटर पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉयलर. दिस टाइप ऑफ स्केल कॉजेज ट्रबल्स मेनली इन हाई प्रेशर बॉयलर. कैल्शियम सल्फेट स्केल इज क्वाइट एडहेरेंट एंड डिफिकल्ट टू रिमूव इवन विद द हेल्प ऑफ हैमर एज वेल एज चाइजर. द थर्ड वन इज हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ मैग्नीशियम साल्ट्स. डिजॉल्व्ड मैग्नीशियम साल्ट्स गेट हाइड्रोलाइज्ड एट हाई टेम्परेचर इनसाइड द बॉयलर फॉर्मिंग मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड प्रेसिपिटेट विच फॉर्म्स अ सॉफ्ट टाइप ऑफ स्केल. सो द वाटर फीडेड टू एज आई डिस्क्राइब्ड इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड द वाटर फीडेड टू द बॉयलर इज अ हार्ड वाटर एंड द हार्डेस्ट कॉजिंग सब्सटेंस इज आइदर कैल्शियम बाइकार्बोनेट और मैग्नीशियम बाइकार्बोनेट. Or we can say it's a chloride of calcium or magnesium, or we can say it may be the sulfates of calcium or magnesium. So we have discussed what happened to the calcium bicarbonate or calcium sulfate with the rise of temperature inside the boiler. So here we will discuss the what happened to the magnesium bicarbonate, or we can say magnesium chlorides within the boiler. Magnesium salts get hydrolyzed within the boiler as the temperature rises. If it's a magnesium bicarbonate, then magnesium bicarbonate with the rise of temperature will be converted to the magnesium carbonate. This magnesium carbonate becomes soluble with water and produce magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide are water insoluble and settle down in the bottom, which is actually the scale causing substance. So remember, with the rise of temperature, calcium bicarbonate is converted to the calcium carbonate, and calcium carbonate is insoluble in the water and become the reason of the formation of the scale. While if the substance is magnesium bicarbonate, then with the rise of temperature, this magnesium bicarbonate is also converted into the magnesium carbonate. But magnesium carbonate is not the source of scale forming substance. As this magnesium carbonate is formed, it becomes soluble in the water and it gives us magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide is insoluble substance settled down in the bottom, and this magnesium hydroxide is actually the scale forming substance produced from the salts of the magnesium. See here, if it's a magnesium chloride, then magnesium chloride upon react with water gives us magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide settled down in the bottom, precipitates out and form the scale. If the impurities present in the hard water are the silica, even if a small quantity of SiO2 is present, it may deposit as calcium silicate, or we can say it may deposit as magnesium silicate. These deposits adhere very firmly on the inner side of the boiler surface and are very difficult to remove. One important source of silica in water is the sand filter, or simply the sand. Here is the assignment for you. Write chemistry involved in removal of temporary as well as permanent hardness of water. Discuss each method in detail. By completing this assignment, you will have a great concept about the hardness causing substance of water and the removal of hardness of water. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.